The even dumber long hair blonde.
I'll trust you. So, do I have that same trust with you?
Yes.
When you're out here playing Survivor, Survivor Barbie, that is the last thing that you want to be coined as. I'm not afraid to fill those shoes because I know I can. But in my head, not necessarily a positive connotation. I'm going to have to prove them all wrong that, you know what, I'm not a weakling. I'm very competitive. I can do it. But I still think it's an uphill battle for me. Russell and I have talked about since the first day about being the final two at the end. So at this point, I'm kind of his wingman, I guess you could say. I definitely think people underestimate me. And I want them to think that, hey, it's really smart for them to take me to the end because they could beat me. You know, use that to my advantage. And if it comes down to me or him, I know I could beat Russell in the very end. Because I would say a lot of other people in the tribe have really been rubbed the wrong way by him. So I'm just trying to not ruffle feathers, steer clear, build good relationships, which is what I'm good at.
This is great.
You got it made, I'm telling you.
That's great.
The night before the merge, Jason, Russell, myself, and Mick had all kind of talked and chatted about who we needed to get to know, who we needed to talk to. Yeah, I mean, I knew that I wanted to meet the girls because it was supposed to be kind of like an underlying girl alliance, possibly. It was important for all of us to kind of get to know the certain ones, but more importantly, trying to figure out who was going to budge and who wasn't. Make no mistake, there are cracks. It's just, are there enough cracks and big enough cracks to get the numbers on our side?
Think of it this way. Baloo still has plenty of people. Plenty. I'm telling you, y'all, he is going to wreak havoc.
Kelly and Laura, I just basically let them know that Eric needed to go now. We have four people. They have eight. It's not a big deal if they lose one. I'm definitely putting my faith in Laura and Kelly, and I'm just going to hope that it works.
He's got to go.
Oh my God.
Seventh person voted out of Survivor Samoa and the first member of our jury. Eric, at seven, that's enough. Need to bring me a torch.
That was perfect.
I'm just actually trying to take it easy, not ruffle any feathers, and just kind of observe.
Oh my word. I have no idea.
I kind of went out for a walk and I stumbled upon this rat or this mouse. I'm so scared. Oh my gosh. A rock or a stick? A rock or a stick? I really could, oh my gosh. I'm like, oh my goodness, that's like something to eat. I was just thinking, I'm starving. I never thought I'd be this hungry in my life.
Oh gosh, okay. Just turn around, eat your snack. Eat your snack, eat your snack. Eat your snack, buddy. Oh gosh, oh my word. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, this is pitiful. Oh my gosh. Oh Lord, have mercy. Oh my word, okay.
Finally, I just hit the rat. It was really hard for me because he was looking at me. He was cute. But I knew how I'm starving. I've never been this hungry in my entire life. I feel like I'm just fading away. At probably day 12, I was thinking, what have I done? Why did I like give my job up? Like, I'm insane. But I was like, you know what? I'm gonna try to keep a good attitude and just try to make the best of it. I was like, oh my word. The shower was amazing.
Oh my goodness.
It felt so good to put soap on my body, shampoo in my hair. The only problem was I ran out of water and I'm like lathered up my whole body. I had already rinsed out the shampoo out of my hair, but I had tons of conditioner. Still have tons of conditioner in my hair right now, which is totally
fine. Next up.
It feels really good to be aligned with Russell. I mean, he is the most powerful player in this game. He knows that whatever he votes, I vote too. So really, he's got two votes no matter what, any way he wants to play it. It may, you know, mess me up in the end, but I've made it this far. So, you know, I'm just gonna trust him and we'll go with it. And I'm hoping that I'll be in the final two. Russell and I are two that you'd probably never put together in a million years. But you know, it's from the first day that we've been aligned. We're still kicking. But yeah, Russell and I, we feed each other information. He doesn't tell me everything because he knows I don't want to lie to anybody and he doesn't want to put me in an uncomfortable situation, but he'll just say, trust me, trust me, trust me. I've got it under control, but you know, that's all I have to go off of. It's my only shot. And I'm gonna go with it. Oh my gosh, Brett is an absolute sweetheart. I mean, Brett and I have had several discussions about the Bible and about some Christian books. I've really enjoyed that, so it's been nice to have that in common.
Brett's an amazing person. If I have to be standing next to a galoo, you know, Brett is awesome. But I've been in with Russell since the very first day. Honestly, it's the hardest thing to balance your heart and your head as far as strategically and then what your heart's telling you. It is so tough. So, you know, hopefully my mind is thinking clear enough to look at the end to be able to win the game. Russell, from the very first day, he told me, I'll take you to the final two if I can trust you. And I was like, you can trust me. I've been completely honest with him, letting him know what's going on, and we've kind of been on the same page with everything. So we actually have quite a bit of power. Two brains are better than one. You know, my whole goal coming into this game was to play the underdog, be underestimated, and just kind of slide through, which is what I've done, and it's gotten me this far.
I think there may be a little bit of strategy involved to wrestle, making us feel like we're not gonna win or that we don't have a chance, but I have news for him. I'm not gonna give up, and I'll just explain to the jury, I don't work the same way as Russell. That would clearly not have worked for me. The girls that were aggressive, they got eliminated early. My strategy was to be myself, and at the end of the day, you know, I wasn't out to get anybody or make anybody look bad. Russell made it clear he was okay with making people look bad. It feels really good to be the last girl standing. I'm just in shock, honestly, that I'm still here. Not only am I here on day 39, Mick, Russell, and myself have beat out 17 other people to be here on the last day, and it feels so good. I feel like I got a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and I'm extremely appreciative for it.
Natalie, people will call you weak. People will say that you're undeserving. But you know what? Why are those characteristics any less admirable as lying, cheating, and stealing? Why does he get a free pass, but your wrong way of playing is admonished? If there's one thing that I learned in this game, it is that perception is not reality. Reality is reality. And you are sitting there, and that makes you just as dangerous as any one of those guys there. You would say that you were probably the least deserving of the title of Soul Survivor. But maybe, just maybe, in an environment filled with arrogance, delusional entitlement, maybe the person who thinks that she's least deserving is probably the most. You got my vote. I hope you get four more. Congratulations.
The winner of Survivor Samoa.